There had been discussion under the previous Congress about some sort of individual stock trading ban for members of Congress as well as potentially their families. That wasn't done under the previous Congress. Speaker Pelosi just couldn't get it done in time. But anyway, it could potentially come back because the Republicans are talking about it once again. Considering how far this goes back and how much oversight you've done of violations of the Stock Act and things like that, I'm curious what you think about the prospects of this being passed under the new Congress.
Well, a whole variety of different politicians have gotten together to sponsor or co-sponsor a new wave of legislation of this sort that would, to again, one extent or another, ban members of Congress, their immediate family members, from trading stocks or even cryptocurrency. I had a long conversation and published an interview just a couple of days ago with Representative Abigail Spanberger, Democrat from Virginia, who says, hey, look, you know, I'm gonna take Kevin McCarthy, the new Speaker of the House, at his word that he's interested in this. And she's pressing forward along with what may be one of the most odd couple partners that we have, Democrat and Republican in Congress. She's sponsoring this bill with Chip Roy, a Republican from Texas, who's about as far to the right, opposite the end of the spectrum, as most Democrats are, as you're going to find. But they agree on this point that, in their opinion, members of Congress should not be trading stocks in companies when members of Congress are voting on legislation that will directly benefit those companies' bottom line. And we can think of lots, but defense contractors in particular come to mind when Congress is passing bills that have billions of dollars worth of price tags, and yet Lockheed Martin and Raytheon and various others, the members are investing in those stocks, and yet they're voting on bills that are going to benefit those companies. So bottom line there is that there is hope for those who would like to see this type of activity banned. Nothing is guaranteed. Kevin McCarthy has not said anything definitively, but hope springs eternal for the proponents of those who would go forward. And Nancy Pelosi's been perhaps predictably very quiet. She has never been a fan of this. And Abigail Spanberger basically blamed Democratic leadership for not bringing this forward last session and letting this die in the vine.
Yeah, 100%. Do we have any idea, by the way, obviously a lot of the conversation has been focused on the House. Do we have any idea of prospects in the Senate if it were to make it to that? Has Biden said, I think he might have commented like last year about this, but do we have any idea of the path going forward were it to make it out of the House?
Joe Biden has been incredibly quiet about this. He's really not said anything material about his support for this. He's not been out front for sure. Chuck Schumer has been very open and saying that he does support this. And let's see what happens in the Senate, but where the action's happening in the House right now.
You know, I'm also curious, obviously the focus has been on legislation, actually banning it. Has there been any discussion of other ways to rein in any of this? You know, I don't know how much can be accomplished through rules for within the caucus, rules within the party. Has there been any talk about the Democrats or the Republicans instituting these sorts of rules for their membership?
Representative Angie Craig back last year floated this and said, hey, well, we don't need legislation, we could do House rules. That never really went anywhere. It was a non-starter. Peter Welch, new senator, he was a representative from Vermont, now Senator Welch. He voluntarily, after violating the Stop Trading on Congressional Knowledge Act, and we wrote an article about it, he just said, all right, I'm done. I'm not gonna trade stocks anymore, neither is my wife. So you can voluntarily quit doing this. You are under no pressure, you are under no obligation as a member of the House or the Senate to trade stocks individually and personally. So if you wanna quit, you can. And we actually had two additional Stock Act violators that Raw Story found. One was Jerry Connolly, a Democrat from Virginia, Seth Moulton, a Democrat from Massachusetts, who were just simply late. They broke the deadline for disclosing stocks that they were actively trading or having their financial advisors trade. So the activity and the practice of this goes on, even if they don't necessarily have to participate, they choose to.
Yeah. Well, I'm definitely gonna be watching this. I think it's fascinating because I know the Republicans would love to use this to stick it to the Democrats. I mean, they even named the bill the Nancy Pelosi whatever bill. But at the same time, do they want to tie their hands behind their backs when it comes to their ability to benefit? We'll have to see. It's a lot easier to propose a bill and then let it just go away. I mean, Nancy Pelosi demonstrated that just a couple of months ago. So we'll
have to see. It's one of the more curious bipartisan issues you're gonna find in Congress over the next year for sure.
100%. Well, you know, thankfully we'll have good people like you and Raw Story watching over that. So as always, Dave, thank you for joining us. We really appreciate it.
Hey, my pleasure. Thank you, John.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.